Hi, beautiful love bugs. Welcome back. I'm Divinely Destined. Welcome back to another video. Welcome back to another video, guys. If you are new here, please take a minute, like the video, share the video. Leave me some red hearts in the comment section tonight. Happy Thursday, happy Friday. Oh, happy day. Yes, all messages will be general. So just take what you need and leave the rest. Happy birthday, Scorpios. Happy Scorpio season. You're bored tonight. You don't have much to do. Go Google your birth chart, guys. It's absolutely free. Yes, see what's going on with your chart, okay? Go see where Scorpio is in your chart. Mars is currently retrograde, okay? Mars, the planet, the action planet, okay? Mars is the planet of aggression, war, all that, okay? Scorpio is ruled by Mars. Aries is ruled by Mars. Mars is currently retrograde in Gemini, okay? Go see what that means for you, collective. Yes, overall energies for us tonight. Remember, beautiful ones, take it how it resonates. Emperor energy, okay? Big Daddy, overall energies coming out for us, collective. Yes. I feel like your divine masculine could be a Leo, Sagittarius, or Aries, or he certainly, or she, has these things in their chart. They have these placements in their charts. I feel like he's very passionate, or he's exuding a lot of passion tonight. You could be in that very passionate, fiery, intense energy as well. Okay. Yes, picking up on Gemini energy. Just speaking about Mars being retrograde in Gemini, and Gemini shows up. Okay. The Knight of Swords. Yeah, I'm picking up on like a boss that's aggravated, and you know, he storms through the building and everyone definitely comes to full attention here. So your divine masculine, or this could be you, okay? You could be in that boss dominant type of authoritative position or energy. When you walk through, people stop, people notice, people definitely pay attention when you come through, okay? Yes, if you are watching this, okay, if you're watching this message inquiring about a twin flame or a soulmate, it appears to be like your soulmate or your twin flame. They're very like authoritative, or they're in that boss-like energy where they command attention and respect, or they always command, or they always get attention, or they command some sort of attention. Take it how it resonates. It looks like he's very aggressive in this energy or authoritative. Yes, he's made up his mind, okay? The Knight of Swords, the Eight of Cups, he's... You can't stop him. You can't stop this person at this point where you can't be stopped, okay? You are in that very authoritative, I'm going to get my way type of energy, and you're not going to be denied, and you're not going to be stopped. Yeah. Some people just simply got to be left behind. That's just life. That's life, collective. Yeah, you may be a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces watching this message tonight. You may be a Libra with justice showing up. Yeah, your twin flame or your soulmate, they may have recently went through a divorce or a breakup, okay? Justice is showing up. Justice is showing up to say, hey, the wrongs will be made right for you. Just hang in there, okay? We got the Eight of Swords. Damn. I definitely see someone driving fast or speeding. Be careful with that. You could have somebody that's locked up tonight and you're sad, you're thinking about him, you're thinking about her, collective. That energy is here. Yep. Or you could be watching this message inquiring. Hi, Michael. You could be watching this message inquiring about a twin flame or a soulmate. They still may be entwined in some sort of situation here that they haven't legally gotten out of, okay? They could still be caught up in a legal situation that they're not completely free from. That could be a marriage, okay? Divorce not finalized. It could be other obligations that they have keeping them tied down at this point and causing them sadness with the Five of Cups. Yes, you may have a lot of water in your chart here. Pisces energy, Cancer energy with the moon here. Your twin flame and your soulmate, okay? They are really, really... They could be cranky, mad, aggressive, because they can't be, you know, they're kind of confined at the moment. They're not, especially if they're still married or they're still going through a divorce process. It's got them kind of like antsy or aggressive or angry, because they kind of want this thing to be over and finalized so they could proceed forward with their life. Okay. So Somebody could be dragging a relationship or a marriage or divorce proceeding. Okay, like somebody could just be like, your twin flame or your soulmate, they could be married to someone that is just refusing to sign a paperwork or continuously delaying the inevitable. Okay, that's got them frustrated as well. Okay, he's secretly feeling, your twin flame, he or she secretly feels some type of way about somebody continuously, you know, prolonging the inevitable. Take it how it resonates. Okay, I'm definitely picking up on the energies of this person, whoever you're watching this message about tonight, honey. I see them as aggressive. I see them as sad. And I also see them as someone who feels confined or restricted, not freely able to move the way they really want to move because of certain circumstances at this particular time. Take the reading how it resonates. Point blank, period. Yes, I see Virgo here. Your twin flame could be a Virgo. Mm-hmm. They could be a Libra. They could also be a Taurus. The Ace of Coins showing up here. Yes. Your soulmate, your twin flame, they got some stuff up the works, okay? And it's just been a process. It's like a waiting game at this point. Yes, it's like a waiting game or just waiting for their opportunity to be freed or for something to be finalized or for something to be materialized into their reality, okay? You may have gas. I'm picking up on someone that has gas. Okay, we got the Queen of Cups. This person, your twin flame, your soulmate, they want to present something nice, something tangible, something that you can see, you could hear, you could touch, you could taste. They may want to present a diamond ring or an engagement ring. They may want to take you to a concert, the opera, something like that. Okay, something tangible, something memorable. This is what I see here. Yes. Mm-hmm. Your twin flame, your soulmate, you know, they see you as someone that's loving and compassionate. Very, very good to them. Very good to them. They also feel like, you know, at some point, they caused you to turn your back on them. And they know that they deserved it. They kept you hanging on by a thread. They kept you stuck in your mind. They kept you, like, just on a bench. And they know that you got tired. And they know that you turned your back for a reason. They know it. They know they caused you great sadness, pain, heartache. The pain that this person put you through is on a soul level. It's deeper than just regular heartache. This is like some deep shit, okay? Yep, they know that they had to face the consequences to their actions, and they are acutely aware that they are facing karma for the actions that they have taken, not only against you, but also other people as well. Yes. This person definitely owes you an apology. They owe you honesty. They owe you truthfulness. Pay attention. The angels may be sending you signs of their presence through feathers this week. Okay, Monday, Tuesday. I'm seeing Sunday and Saturday. Okay, those may be, you know, the particular days that you may find feathers, see feathers on the television. You may see feathers on a commercial in your dreams. Okay, the color red is significant here. There's a lot of passion here. Okay, yes. Mm-hmm. This person has certainly, this person certainly has not always been forthcoming and upright with you or straightforward with you. Yes, they feel some type of way. It's like this person is saying, she's mine, he's mine, he's mine, she's mine. Okay, yes, but they got to show you, point blank, period. The secrets, the lies, the cover-ups, the illusions. All that shit caught up with them. Yes. What you don't see and what you may not know is they have walked away from something or someone's, or they're in the process of freeing themselves and being freed from certain situations, circumstances, and people. They were most likely part of one reason why this person, your twin flame or your soulmate, has been away so long or has had no contact with you for so long is due to karma. Due to them being hemmed up in spiritual court, spiritual jail, okay? Mm-hmm. They see you as the ultimate wish fulfillment with the Ace of Coins. Yes, you are currently operating fluently in your North Node energy. Your twin flame knows it. Your soulmate know it. They know that they definitely hold a special place in your destiny. Okay, if that makes sense, they already know their purpose, or they already know that they serve a purpose or they have a purpose in your life. Point blank, period. They know who you are. Period. It's been confirmed. Yes, I definitely pick up on a lot of passion, a lot of intensity, a lot of sexuality, a lot of sensuality, a lot of aggression, a lot of pent-up stress, a lot of pent-up frustration. A lot of this is sexual pent-up frustration that the masculine feels tonight. Period. Okay, point blank, period. Yeah, he may be drinking excessively, or he has been drinking quite more than usual lately. Okay, he's definitely been feeling some type of way. Yes. The Knight of Wands and the Ace of Cups. And this is like somebody drinking and masturbating. Someone masturbating, crying. Someone all in their damn feelings, okay? Masturbating, aggravated, frustrated, but not getting the release that they need at the end of the day. Yes, it's coming. It's coming, but it ain't coming like he know it could come when he's with you. Okay, take it how it resonates. Yes, your person, your twin flame, your soulmate, they see you as an earth angel. They see you as a divine being, okay? They see you as someone that brings great balance. They see you as someone also patient with them, okay? Like you may be like the only person that they've ever had in a life that exhibited so much patience with their ass, okay? And they took that shit for granted. Yeah, you may be a Scorpio here. Yeah, I'm hearing that song, I'm Addicted, by Charlie Wilson. I feel like I hit the lotto. Go listen to that song. Yeah, I see November the 19th, that Scorpio energy. You may be a Sagittarius as well. November the 23rd, Sagittarius energy shows up. The Nine of Wands. Your person, they may be refraining from sex or not. They may be restraining themselves back, okay? Holding themselves back, okay? The way, you know, I feel like this person used to be wild as fuck. But on some level, they got tamed, or they're in the process of being tamed here. They definitely got some pent-up sexual frustration and energies. It's just coming up. Yeah. Yeah, your twin flame or your soulmate, they may have been married to someone that was dominant, controlling, bitchy, bossy, mean as fuck, okay? Mm-hmm. Made him feel like he wasn't good enough, wasn't worthy enough, or it made her feel like she wasn't adequate enough or couldn't get it right, okay? This is the person they chose over you, or this was their karma that they got for fucking over you. Mm-hmm. She looks good. Yeah, she looks good. But it was more to her than just that, okay? She looked good, but she caused a lot of headache and stress on the masculine. He looks like he's aged 15, 5, 10, 20 years here. Yeah. He's looking a little dirty, isn't he? Disheveled, not shaved, need a haircut. Yeah, he look like he's been through hell, doesn't he? You see that dog back there? That dog represents you. That dog represents the loyalty that you've always had for him. You still watching out for his ass. You still watching out for him. He know it. He know you've been patient. I spoke about it already. You see? You already know. You already know. We got the Three of Coins. Taurus, Capricorn, Virgo. Yeah. He may be working himself silly at this time. Okay, your twin flame, your soulmate, they may be a she, okay? The person may be a female or a male. Take it how it resonates. It appears to be like they're working themselves silly here, okay? He's exhausted. She's tired. She comes home. He comes home. And he's met with bitchiness, angry faces, hostility, okay? Something like that. Take it how it resonates. Yeah, it looks like he's working harder than ever. He may be taking, you know, more work, overtime, more jobs just to be away from home or something like that. Okay, we got the Nine of Coins. He may be single. They may be single. They're definitely working on that, okay? Take it how it resonates. They may be literally in the process of a divorce as you watch this message, okay? Yes. He sees you as fruitful, abundant, prosperous. Now, you may be saying, I'm struggling financially. I don't really have a lot of money, and I don't really have a lot of this. I don't really have a lot of that. But that's not how he sees you. Even if you don't have a lot of money, or you don't have this, or you don't have that, he still sees you as someone that is abundant, fruitful, someone capable of manifesting, someone that has proven that they can manifest. He sees you as someone definitely different than the rest. He sees you in his dreams, too. The Four of Swords. Mm-hmm. Can't help it, I'm addicted. Okay. Mm-hmm. I see that. I'm getting some explicit messages. Okay. Yeah. Some erections while he's sleeping. He may be dreaming about you sexually. Okay. Yep. He's definitely dreaming about you. Look, the hermits. Mm-hmm. Your twin flame, your soulmate. They may be a Virgo. They have Virgo in their chart. He's definitely aged. They have aged. They may be older than you. Or they may have literally just aged. You know what I'm saying? Life has really been kicking them in the ass, huh? Pisces energy with the Hangman. He don't want to get out of bed because the dream is so damn good. You're riding him. He feels so good. He don't want to wake up. Okay. Yes, he's having sexual dreams, or he's had some sexual dreams. They've had sexual dreams of you. Yeah, he tired of masturbating. He tired of them dreams. He want to see you. He want to feel you. He want to touch you. They want to be with you. Yeah, we got Scorpio energy with the Death card. It's darkness and gloom all around. But you see that white flower in his hand? That represents something about him that still has hope. That hasn't given up hope. Okay? There's something in him that has not died. Okay? He may not see it. He may not be able to see it, but it's there. Okay? Yes. The hopes, the dreams, the desires, they're there. They may not be visibly able to be seen by the untrained eye, but they're there. He may have them so buried and deep inside that he doesn't know that they're still there, but they're there. Or he may, she may. Yeah, I see Libra energy here, Taurus energy, Scorpio energy here. The planet of love, Venus, is a pretty big theme here. Your person is a romantic, okay? They're romantic, they're handsome, they're beautiful. You may not be able to tell it because they age quite a bit. They may need a good shower, a good shave, a good bath, a good hairdo, something like that, but it's there. There's a beauty around them. It looks like the eyes, okay? You can see the aging around the eyes. You can see the sadness, the gloom, the weariness of life around the eyes. You can see the happiness, also the lips and the corner of the mouth. You are definitely able to tell the signs of the things that they have been through, even if they never speak it, okay? You see how he got that hat on his head? Yes, and you see his throat is protected and also the heart chakra. Okay, your person is on game. You may not realize it, but he's definitely been watching tarot, possibly booking tarot readings. He may have a connection or a relationship or a tie to someone in the spiritual community. They got him right, okay? He may be praying more, reading the Bible, going to church, okay? Yes, bless you. He may have had a spiritualist inform him to keep his head covered, protect his crown, protect your throat, okay, and your heart chakra against spiritual attacks. Mm-hmm. It's like he's wearing the ultimate poker face here. You think you got him, but you really don't. He's shrouded, okay? He has his full armor of protection on, point blank period. I like this reading. I like this masculine. That's why you can't count people out. You can't judge people. Okay? You can't just say what you think is going to happen to people. These divine beings are divine beings. Okay? At the end of the day, yes, we got the Four of Wands, twin flame. Here's your confirmation. Some of you guys are watching this. This is going to be a twin flame message. Point blank period. Yep. He may have hastily married someone, just going based off solely on how he felt or how she made him felt or how he made her felt. He didn't look deep before he leaped. Okay, you know how they say it's better to marry late than to marry wrong. Okay, he may have impulsively rushed a wedding or a relationship towards the altar, and it was a disaster. Okay, we've all been there. Some of these masculines are still in marriages, honey. Don't be deceived. Don't get your heads so far up in the clouds that you fail to realize that, okay? Some feminists know that, okay? Some of them are still married. Some of them are in the process of breaking up. Some of them are in the process of divorcing. Some of them are in the process of spiritual awakenings, okay? Spiritual encounters. Yes, spiritual things. This is what I'm hearing. Gaining more spiritual insight and awareness. Yes. Being more alert and attuned to the messages, okay, that they're getting from the spiritual realms. they're up on game. They have someone that has been helping them, assisting them, possibly by them meeting you. That was the first big sign that they got, okay? That got them on a path. Yes, the high priestess that got them on the path. Now look at him. He's listening to his intuition. Or he know he should, okay? Your twin flame may be a master spiritualist. You may not be aware. You may be aware. He calls you in the spirit. Mm-hmm. She calls you in the spirits. You guys are spiritually connected no matter what. Especially twin flames, okay? There is no cord to cut, honey. There's no cord to cut. Yes, I'm hearing he's listening to a spiritual team. I've been picking up on this for the last three to four messages. The ancestors are really coming out to back the masculines here. Okay? They may have not initially understood the importance of listening to their spiritual team, but I'm pretty sure with the high priestess here, they are now. They are now. Yes. The Six of Swords. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like everything that he loves is in this boat. And his spiritual team is guiding him. Okay? He may not physically have everyone that he loves in the boat, but they're in his heart, they're in his soul, they're in his mind. And therefore, they're in the boat with him, and they are being spiritually guided. He's taking them along, right along with them on his journey. Okay? Take it how it resonates. His spiritual team is showing up to let you know that they got him. Okay? Yes? Mm-hmm. Look at this Queen of Wands. The Queen of Wands, she has been the biggest thorn in the side of the Divine Empresses in the year 2022. Doing all kind of black magic and spell work. Sending all kind of hexes and attempting to. Negative energies. She's trying to do everything. Well, she was definitely in those energies in the year 2022. Or he. Or multiple. Okay? Trying to keep these two apart. Or to try to keep the masculine. You know, go watch some old tarot readings of mine. Or any tarot reader. And you're going to see the Queen of Wands. She was a heavy theme in the year 2022. Yes. Mm-hmm. Your twin flame could have married a Leo. For sure. Okay? He could have married a Sagittarius. Also an Aries. Yes. You see that look right there? You see how the Queen of Wands is looking? Can you imagine that look every day? I would be scared too. He was probably scared to leave or something like that. We got the Ten of Cups. The Ten of Cups. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I can give you what you want. I can give you what you desire. I am your true love. Okay? I'm telling you, the Queen of Wands is bad. You gotta watch her. She may have tried to cloak your energy this year. Or to try to, you know, yeah, imitate or mimic your energies. She may have had the masculine thinking that she was the one. She was the true love. She was the twin flame. It's something like that going on with the Queen of Wands here. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like when a guy is having a bad day. He goes to the bar. He sits at the bar and this strange woman appears. She says, I can take the stress away. I can help you relieve some of that stress. Hmm. You know? Sometimes men fall for these Queen of Wands. Mm-hmm. Yes. I love it. Look at the Two of Swords. The masculine said, no, the hell I'm not. Okay? It's like he's got her blocked. Okay? He's got the Queen of Wands blocked. Or he's catching up on what... He's being brought up to speed on her game. Or he's been brought up to speed on her game. He may have a Queen of Wands blocked tonight. Okay? Your twin flame may have a Queen of Wands blocked. Your soulmate, they may have someone blocked tonight. Yep. The two of Swords and the Seven of Wands. Yes. He's not playing with somebody tonight. He's not falling for the good looks and the good charm. She's not falling for that shit. Okay? You got to come harder than that because he's more spiritually aware or he's becoming more spiritually aware or his spiritual team has already shown him certain things about this Queen of Wands. Okay? The Two of Swords, that's a blockage. The Seven of Wands, that's a blockage. He ain't playing with this Queen of Wands or this Queen of Swords, okay? He's very defensive, and he should be, okay? This could be the baby mama, mm-hmm, baby daddy, mm-hmm. He could have met this Queen of Wands when he was young or young-minded or in a more immature state of mind or being, okay? He could have married her young. I spoke about it. He married her young or impulsively, or he jumped into a relationship or a marriage or a living situation fairly quickly. with this woman, or she fell for him quite quickly and moved the relationship forward rather fast. Take it how it resonates. It looks like they moved in, they had a kid, they got married, all that, okay? Possibly at a time in his life, at a time in her life when they were emotionally immature, okay? Or at a time in their life where they thought that, you know, we all have karmic cycles. He thought she was the one, period. It looks like it's over. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you and your twin flame may be literally on different sides of the earth, okay? The world tonight. He may be in another country than you tonight. She may be in another country than you tonight. Their origins and their upbringing may have been in a totally different country, nationality than you. Point blank, period. It looks like something is over. With this Queen of Wands, with the Queen of Wands, third party situation is over. You see this? I keep picking up on this number three. I picked up number three. The twin flame, the soulmate, at least three partners in the year 2022. I mean, that's a minimum. Could be less, could be more, okay? But there's been at least three. Mm-hmm. Lord help him if he had three Queen of Wands this year. Looks like he's had a Queen of Wands, he's had a Queen of Swords, okay? Mm-hmm. Queen of Wands, she's very psychic, very gifted on the spiritual realms. The Queen of Swords, she's a survivor. The Queen of Swords is a survivor. She survived things. She's a lifelong survivalist. The Queen of Swords, she can be the most bitchiest, nastiest, cold-hearted mother you can ever imagine. But the Queen of Wands will get you every time because she can work her way in the door with her magic. And you'll be under her spell before you know it, okay? Yep. There go the magic. You'll be under her spell before you know it. Yeah. Yes. Whew. I'm hearing casting a lot of illusions, okay? The Queen of Wands could be doing spell work or have done spell work on the masculine to cause financial hardships for him this year. Mm-hmm. Yep. She or he could have up to 3 to 4, 6, 7, 8 kids, okay? Your twin flame, your soulmate, they could have a football team. Okay, 3 different baby mamas, 4 different baby daddies, take it how it resonates. There's definitely the energies of the Queen of Wands working with a spiritualist, okay? This could be also the Queen of Wands being a spiritualist. This could be the Queen of Wands having an ancestor or doing things to connect with the deceased or ancestors or something like that. The Queen of Wands is not, she's not nobody to fucking play with. Whew. We got Aquarius energy with the Star card. Yes, the Star card. He definitely needs some healing. It looks like the Queen of Wands could have contacted a spiritualist, or she's been doing spiritual work, trying to, you know, hoping to heal the marriage at some point. Take it how it resonates. Yeah. I'm going to go ahead and close this out. Oh, we got the Ten of Coins. The Ten of Coins. It's all about the money. It's all about the money at the end of the day. Yes, the King of Swords, the Queen of Swords, that's a divorced couple. That's a divorced husband and wife. That's baby mama, baby daddy, not together, baby. That's a breakup, okay? It's been coming for a long time, between 7 months, 7 years, 10 years. It's inevitable, okay? He may have stayed in this karmic cycle way past the expiration dates. Way past the expiration date. He could have been loyalty for his children, you know, loyalty because of the children. You know how they go. Yes, we got the Fool energy. Maybe he was just a fool in love, you know. When a man is in love, ain't nothing you can say. It's nothing you could do. It's nothing you can do. He has to see for himself. She has to see for herself. That's it. The Five of Swords. He had to see for himself. Yes, he could have definitely been dealing with someone that was narcissistic, mean, cold, brutal, wanting to win and defeat him at all costs. You don't leave. You leave when I say you leave, okay? Somebody like that. Mm-hmm. He could have been a narcissistic, mean-ass, brutal-ass, heartless asshole this year as well. Take it how it resonates. There's been some aging here. He may have a lot of gray hair. He's definitely sprouting some gray hair, especially if he's over 30, 40 years old. He could have gray hair in his 20s as well. they are exhibiting some gray hair somewhere, and there's something going on with the eyes. There's something about the eyes. He may not be sleeping that good. You could tell the wear and tear on this masculine. It's just here. Mm-hmm. He spreaded himself too thin. He wore himself out by not resting properly or something like that. Spreading himself too fucking thin. Being a Casanova. Jumping bed to bed to bed. House to house to house. He may have been a player this year. A cheater. A dog. Unfaithful. Take it how it resonates. Yeah. There's definitely the energies of a connection that haunts him tonight. And, you know, we're not going to act like we're surprised about what connection that is. This could definitely indicate the Queen of Wands doing spell work to try to cause the masculines to suffer great harm. I definitely see deities, demonic energies, okay? All that shit happened in the year 2022. All because of this destined love connection that this person shares with you. Okay? Point blank period. It wore him out. It wore you out. It's wearing you both out. It's the wear and tear is obvious here. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and close it out. The wear and tear is obvious. There's definitely the indications of this person being guarded. Okay, he may not want to date right now. She may not want to date right now. Or she's very guarded and protective about who she dates. This person, your twin flame, definitely needs to be careful about who they lay down with. Okay, who they lay down with. Because it's very likely that they had something attached to them this year. They got something attached to them this year. Because they slept with the wrong person. They put their penis in the wrong vagina. They got a spiritual disease, possibly an STD. He could have been studying extensively, trying to figure out how to get this shit off of him. Take it how it resonates. If you want to go further and you want to book me, I'm available. Happy Friday. Take care, guys.